Hello everyone, starting a new series, lesson number one. So I hope everything is working. Oh, I see Blake is back. What's up, Blake? Missed you around. Okay, so we're starting a new series with the Baal Sulam articles. We'll start with the article, The Peace. What we saw from the frequently asked questions that some basic knowledge is required or is lacking. So we decided to go deeper into Hey to Lina as well. We started to go deeper into the articles. Shalom also to Jim. What's up? Okay, so let's start with the article. So this series doesn't have an intro because they didn't have the time to make an intro for that. So we'll manage without it. You have the link to the article in case you don't have the book Kabbalah for the student. You have the link for the article in the description box. If you have the book, so it's on page 2, where's the page? 261. Okay. So, The Peace. So, we'll just read it and then get some questions and then talk about it. So, if you have questions, just write them down. Just keep them on topic, please. So, The Peace. Session number one. This is exciting, starting a new session, starting a new series. An empirical scientific research about the necessity of the work of God. Okay, so there is something that is called the work of God. Question, what does it mean? And Baal HaSulam wants to explain that in an empirical scientific way. Why do we need that? Okay, this thing that is called the work of God, whatever that is. And then it opens with a few quotes. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lay down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and the little child shall lead them, and it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time to recover the remnant of his people that shall be left from Ashur and from Egypt, from Patras and from Cush and from Elam and from Shinar and from Hamat and from the islands of the sea. Okay, so this is Isaiah is writing that from his attainment in the spiritual reality. And maybe later on we'll see what does it mean. And also, it says in the Zohar, it says in the Masechet Oktzin, sorry, Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta said, God did not find a vessel to hold the blessing for Israel, but peace. As it says, the Lord give strength to his people, the Lord bless his people with peace. So again, many questions, what is God, what is Israel, what does it mean a vessel, what does it mean the peace, etc., etc. So let's dive into it. I hope you see the, is it big enough? I don't know, like, can you see it well enough on the screen? Let me know. Let's see if we have any comments about the writings. Okay, no comments yet. Can somebody tell me if the text is clear enough from my understanding to go to, Blake, don't dive into the material. I'm asking about the text right now. So nobody's commenting about the text. Oh, okay, so hopefully you open the link or you have the book or you see it good enough. Okay, after having demonstrated in previous articles the general form of his work, whose essence is but the love of others, practically determined as bestowed upon others, meaning that the actual manifestation of love of others is bestowed of God, of goodness upon others. Love of others should be determined as bestow upon others, which is best suited for its content, aiming to ensure that we will not forget the aim. Okay, so this requires a bit of a clarification. So actually this article, The Peace, is part of a contrast of a few articles that Baal HaSulam writes, and the articles that were before that are called Matan Torah, the giving of the Torah, and the Arvut, which means the mutual guarantee, and in which Baal HaSulam actually explains pretty straightforward what we've talked about also in previous series, that there is one general law, which is called the Creator, and this law is the law of bestow, and this is the field that we are all exist, that we all exist in, and the goal of this law is to bring us to be similar to Him, to attain what He His, what He is, or what, or the pleasure, or the light, or the information that He holds. That's why this force created the will to receive. And this will to receive is created in an endless way, like endless deficiency, because the Creator have endless abundance to give. The problem is that from the beginning, these two are opposite, and because they are opposite, the vessel doesn't feel the Creator. Actually, it descends until a state in which it is in complete darkness. This is called our world. And in this complete darkness, the only way to come back to attainment with the Creator, to actually sense the call of creation, whatever the Creator has to give to the creature, we need to correct ourselves, meaning we need to acquire an intention in order to bestow. So there is a goal of creation, which is to fill ourselves with all the light that the Creator has given us. But because the Creator is a complete bestow, complete love, and we're complete deficiency, complete lack, there is the correction of creation. Okay, so we need to actually correct ourselves. Correction, that's how you write correction. Not sure about that. Let me check. Okay, so what do we do? Double R. Okay, so what do we do when we are in a complete opposite state from the Creator? And because we are in a complete opposite state, we're just like a minus, we're just like a minus element in a positive field or whatever. I don't know how you want to imagine that. And since we're not in a point of balance with the field, the gap between where we are to where we need to be is felt in us as pain. So what do we need to do in a reality in which we are in complete darkness? We don't know the rules. We don't understand the system. We don't know how to attain the Creator. What do we actually need to do in practice? So Baal Sam says that's very simple. We need to. That's why we were giving society as a whole, that we need to find people who are similar to us, meaning wanting to attain the Creator. These people are usually called Israel because they are straight to the Creator. It's called Yeshar Kel. Not talking about the corporal Israel, talking about the genuine original Israel, the group of people that actually gathered around Abraham in order to attain the upper force, and from that later on the nation evolved. So you need to find other people, and although each one of you is an egoist, if everyone acts towards the other like he's in bestow, what is calling love of the other, or giving them goodness or whatever, and so the gap between what you want to be and what you act towards the others is called your prayer for correction. And also, because everybody is acting towards you in a plus, you get impression and example of what you want to be, so it increases your desire towards spirituality. So this is the practical Kabbalah in a group, or in a ten, or whatever you want to call that. And the most important thing is, by doing so, we actually make ourselves similar to the Creator. So just like He bestows, we want to bestow. And this is called that we allow the light, or the Torah, or whatever you want to call that, the light that reforms, to correct us and bring us into the state of the Creator. That's, in a nutshell, the basis of Kabbalah. And this is also called the work of God. Why? Because what is the work of God? It means that God, meaning the Creator, the law of bestow, actually does everything. He is the source and he is the goal, and he operates in every point of the way. So he's like the source, the reason, he's the goal to attain it. And every moment, every action, every second, doesn't matter how you want to define it, with time, out of time, he's the one that operates. So the necessity for the work of God, meaning that we need to reveal how he operates on us. And we can reveal that only if we become similar to him. This is called correction. Okay, so he wants to now in an empirical study, like in a scientific way, to proven this concept. Okay, so this is what we're going to do in this article. Good. So let's move a bit forward. It's good that you're writing questions. Keep writing them down. I'll refer to them all soon. Now that we know for certain the conduct of his work, meaning to the bestowed, there still remains to inquire whether this work is acceptable to us by faith alone, meaning that somebody told me and I believe that. And also in faith, we have different levels. We have like a fanatic faith that somebody tells me and I just believe it because I was educated like that, or everybody say it is so. There is faith, and this is called faith under reason or below reason. There is faith in reason, which means that I understand that this is somebody that I should believe, like I go to a doctor, and although I haven't studied medicine myself, I believe him that now I need to do like this and like that. Or scientists, for example, that tell me that the earth is round, so although I haven't checked that myself, I believe them in reason, and there is faith above reason, which is a spiritual thing, and maybe we'll talk about that later. But he's saying, should we accept it only by faith alone, without any scientific empirical basis, or whether we also have an empirical basis for it? This is what I want to demonstrate in the essay before us, but first I must thoroughly demonstrate the subject itself, meaning who it is who accepts our work. Okay, so he wants to talk about the concept of the Creator before he wants to talk about the work of the Creator, or God and the work of God. But I'm not an enthusiast, I cannot pronounce that, that's okay. Part of the words that I cannot pronounce so early in the morning. How do you pronounce that? Please.
Enthusiast.
Let me not forget that. Hopefully I won't forget that. But I'm not an enthusiast of formative philosophy, since I dislike theoretically based studies, and it is well known that most of my contemporaries agree with me, for we are too familiar with such foundations, which are rickety foundations, and when the foundation fluctuates, the whole building tumbles. Okay, and this is very important, because in Kabbalah, like if there is something that really Kabbalists don't like, it's philosophy, as a concept that people out of their brain or mind or whatever start to invent stuff. So Kabbalah really tries to cleave on to matter, and in a sense it's very materialistic, although it sounds weird here that Kabbalah is talking about forces and spiritual world and a sixth sense or something that we don't feel in our five senses. On the other hand, it's very materialistic, very empirical, very down to earth. So Kabbalists really don't like philosophy, and that's why they want to prove everything from their experience. Now the question is, like, is their way of research acceptable by us, or do we take the empirical findings that they bring as something that we can actually understand in our five senses? These are other questions, but Balasuan wants to say that he doesn't like philosophy and he wants to find the real foundations, like the essence of things proven from experience. Therefore, I have come here to speak only through critique of empirical reason, beginning from the simple recognition no one disagrees with, through proving analytically, separating the various elements in an issue. Yes, analysis is about separation, until we come to determining the uppermost topic, and it will be tested another word I cannot pronounce in this morning so early, sorry. Synthetically, how would you pronounce that? Like synthetically, let's see. Oh, I don't get these options for this word synthetically on Google. Oh, this is so sad. Let's go into dictionary.
Synthetic.
And just synthetic. Whatever. So, synthetically, this is going to be, which means the connection and unity between matters, such as inference and all the more so. Okay, so actually in scientific research, that's what they want to do, what they want to say. There are two ways, either separating the thing to the part, examining each part, then bringing them all together into one picture. This is analytically and synthetically. I made it now. How his work is confirmed and reframed by simple recognition from the practical aspect. Okay, so this is what he wants to talk about the creator in a very scientific way, and that's what we're gonna do in this essay, starting with contradictions in providence next time. But now let's use the time we have left for the questions we have, please. Wow, and we have a lot of them. Nice. Hello from Las Vegas. Hello from Petah Tikva. Okay. No questions on Facebook, all the questions on YouTube. So many questions. Blake is asking, from my understanding, the will to bestow does the work and the will to receive is worked on. Is that right? Yes, that is right. Text is clear. Okay, good. Yoel is asking, why is this Congress the last physical Congress I had? Okay, this is a question about Congress, not related to the lesson. Hello to Lear. We are victorious. What was the name? Again, I forgot your name, sorry. In the Torah, this is the guy with Jesus stuff. Okay, so he's like to make fun with Jesus stuff. Does he have a question not about Jesus? Yes. Is the peace you are referring to in Kabbalah? Yeah, peace actually in Kabbalah refers to a completion of two different things, okay? So if you have two contradictions, two opposite forces, just like the will to receive and the will to bestow, the peace means bringing them into oneness, okay? Can we achieve the goal of creation when surrounded by idol worshippers? Isn't that what Abraham did? Yeah, Abraham is the point inside of us, in each one of us, that decides to attain the upper force, the one force that operates everything, none else beside him, and so he breaks all the idols. What does it mean? That everything that in my corrupted perception of reality, Shayech. Let me check this. Associate. Good, that's a good word. Okay, so in my corrupted perception of reality, I associate everything in my world to something else. So if I get a ticket, I think it's the officer. If I get problems at home, I think it's my wife. If I get problems at work, I think it's my boss. I think that the sports has its own laws, and each country has their own laws, and physics has its own laws. Meaning that I associate to different forces different laws. And breaking the idols means that I actually come to reveal that everything comes from one source and there is one law that moves it all. How does temporary work performed in the screen turn into the screen? We haven't talked about that. What is the meaning of the word above? For example, faith above reason. It seems easy to understand, but in fact, I don't understand at all. Above means more important. Okay? So do you see faith as more important than reason, or reason more important than faith, or the same as equal? Okay, Black is offering other options, and also Victorious, or Jesus, whatever you want to call him. Like thoughts are above, okay, this is a dialogue. Okay, so no more questions about the topic. Okay, I thought actually we had more questions. Okay, so let's move forward so we have more time. This is not good. Okay. Contradictions in providence. Every reasonable person who examines the reality before us finds two complete opposites in it. When examining creation, its reality and conducts, there is an apparent and affirmed leadership of great wisdom and skill, both regarding the formation of reality and the securing of its existence in general. Let us take the making of a human being as an example. The love and pleasure of his progenitors is its first reason, guaranteed to perform its duty. And when the essential drop is extracted from the father's brain, Providence has very wisely secured a safe place for it, which qualifies it to receive life. Providence also gives it its daily bread in the exact amount, and it also prepares a wonderful foundation for it in the mother's womb so that no stranger may harm it. Yeah? So he gives this example of how life comes to be, or human life, as an example for the precision and accuracy and the efficiency that we find in nature, and how in many, many layers and aspects, nature is so complete and so genius, and so, I don't have such a high vocabulary in English for that, but we see this perfection in nature. And also we see that in how life come to be from the moment that the seed leaves the father's body into the mother, and how it evolves there, and also after that how everything is taken care of. It tends to its every need like a trained nanny who will not forget it even for a moment until it has acquired the strength to emerge into our world. At that time, Providence briefly lends it just enough strength to break the walls that surround it, and like a trained armed warrior, it breaks an opening and emerges into the world. Then, too, Providence does not abandon it. Like a loving mother, it brings it to such loving, loyal people it can trust, called mother and father, to assist it through its days of weakness until it grows and is able to sustain itself. As men, so are all the animals, plants, and objects. All are wisely and mercifully cared for to ensure their own existence and the continuation of the species. Okay, so this is something amazing in nature. Also, the fact that we have actually natural love for this sack of proteins that exits the mother's body, and suddenly we have feelings for that. Otherwise, we would just return it. Like everyone who was a father or a mother knows that if it was a product bought on Amazon after a month without sleep, or needing to invest so much in that without getting anything back, we were just sending back. But no, we have this natural love inside of us, programmed by nature, that compels us or enforces us to promise the continuation of the species. And this is something very, very interesting. But those who examine that reality from the perspective of provision, not from creation of reality and continuation, but from provision and persistence of existence, can clearly see great disorder and confusion, as though there were no leader and no guidance. Everyone does that which is right in his own eyes, building himself on the ruin of others. The evil thrive and the righteous are trampled mercilessly. Bear in mind that this oppositeness set before the eyes of every sensible educated person has preoccupied humanity even in ancient days, and there are many methods to explain these two apparent opposites in providence which occupy the same world. Okay, so this contradiction between the perfection in nature to this constant war and flaws in nature is one of the main topics that humanity had to deal with, and every one of us as an individual as well. That on one hand we feel that everything should be simple, connected, right, good, in its place. On the other hand, we feel these contradictions and emptiness and fights and things we cannot justify or explain to ourselves at all. And how these two coexist, meaning a system that is ordered by a precise law and this complete chaos and constant war of one in another. So this is something that Balsam wants to explain first, how humanity tried to solve that, and then later on he will show the Kabbalistic solution, and from then he will continue to deal with this question of peace in the world. Okay, so that was about that. Let's see if we have questions. Okay. No questions, just how many more verses do I have to experience? Okay, breaking is also something we haven't talked about. I missed the first 14 minutes. How do I replay it? Well, actually, you can go to the YouTube channel, subscribe to it, and once it's over, once we finish, which is in 1 minute, the video would upload and stay there, and you can rewatch it every time. Say we know nothing really within the system or universe, really? Okay, so this is not a question. Okay, so no more question. So actually, if you just joined, or you, this is the first lesson of this series, so you can actually just rewatch it, the first session later on, and join us next time. If you haven't seen the previous series, meaning the ones we did with the frequently asked questions, or the ones before that about Kabbalah for beginners, then you probably don't know that we're broadcasting every Monday, Thursday morning Israel time, or it's like Sunday, Wednesday, late night New York time. Soon we'll move in Israel into daylight saving time, and then the hours will go back to being more normal for the students in North America. And if you want to learn in a more in-depth way than these lessons, then you have the free online Kabbalah course with the link in the description box. That's it for now. See you next time in lesson number 2. And we started a very important subject, and we'll continue it next time. And since we don't have this intro thing, then I'll just say goodbye, and we'll wrap it up with that. Bye-bye.